So yeah, how has the tour been going so far?
So far it's been great. It's mostly been warm-up shows. By our standards, it's sort of on the smaller side. We've only been playing to a couple thousand people. So this is, coming here is going to be our first really big, properly big shows that we've done so far. So
cool, man. And it'll be nice to be stretching out some of those songs and adding some new ones to the repertoire.
Yeah, yeah. We've only, so far this year, we've only been playing new songs. So, for the most part.
What I really like about you guys is that each album seems incredibly different and defined on its own terms. Mm-hmm. Is that something you seek to do each time, or does it just happen that way?
I guess both. Mm. It sort of just happens that we seek to do that each time.
Yeah. Yeah. And it works, right?
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah. That's the goal, for sure.
With Reflector, I really like the marketing to sort of hint that this thing was coming out and was happening. Who looks after that stuff? Because I thought it was quite smart and quite cool how that sort of rolled out.
Mm. It's a pretty big group effort, pretty team effort. I mean, we're not necessarily marketing-driven people, but I think we all get quite enthusiastic about sort of making public, you know, causing confusion publicly, or making, you know, interesting kind of artistic, trying to make artistic statements publicly. And that interfaces kind of well with the people who are behind us helping to get the music out there. But we always just really like to have fun whenever we're taking public steps. So it kind of, we don't really think about it as marketing, although it ends up being that, but it's more like us trying to do artistically fun or interesting things in public.
Yeah, mixing up a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah.
What, I was curious as well, I'm seeing her tomorrow night for the first time.
Oh, cool.
How did it come about working with Spike and doing that? Because that soundtrack sort of obviously came out at the same time as this album.
Right. It came about just from having worked with him on the Suburbs stuff. Mm. He did the video for the Suburbs, kind of short film. Yeah. And then as he was working on this film, he just kept wanting us to work on it, work on the music for it, and asking us about it. And, and at various times it seemed like it wouldn't be possible just for time-wise, and then we just decided to go all in and do it. So sort of crunch time for the record at the same time as it was crunch time for that soundtrack, and it was a little mental, but it worked out.
Good morning, Theodore.
Good morning.
You have a meeting in 5 minutes. You want to try getting out of bed?
You're too funny.
So you were both, you're working on them both at the same time?
Yeah.
That's madness.
Yeah, it was madness.
And it happens that this film has sort of ended up being on a lot of people's number one movie.
Yeah, it turned out really
list,
well.
You know?
Yeah, it turned out really well, that film. I think it's great.
Yeah, cool, man.
Yeah.
Well, look, okay, obviously Reflector's out, so you're sort of touring on the back of that now. What is it about this record that you enjoy the most?
As a record, or in terms of playing it live?
Playing it live. Like, are the tracks that bounce out at you that you really like getting stuck into, or as a whole? Because, I mean, I quite like that you are just playing newer stuff and not just relying on the hits, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it definitely represents a little bit of a gear shift for us, really, the sort of dancier aspects of the new record really being that, having been a goal that we were aiming for from the get-go. Mm. And so then aiming for trying to become that live band. It's kind of like, you know, setting your sights out ahead of you, sort of being out a little bit outside of your comfort zone and outside of your musical comfort zone, and then aiming for that. So it's sort of trying to raise the bar for ourselves in terms of aiming for something different, and that's maybe slightly beyond our capacities as a band in the past. And that, so then aiming for that and having that be what brings us forward is kind of throwing the goal out, you know, in front of yourself and then running for it. So kind of trying to become a band that can play dancier sets and maintain that kind of energy instead of the kind of sets that we sort of built ourselves on as a live band.
So has that danceability always been something you've wanted to aim towards, or is that sort of something that's formed more recently?
Because I mean, it's something, you know? Yeah, it works. It's something that we've already had to some degree, but never in an extended way, never like over a long arc of an album or over a live set. but there's definitely always been parts of our live set where people have just really gone crazy and danced, but it would sort of happen for a section of a song or for one song. And
yeah,
we just wanted to push that a little bit. And so it's fun and it's really interesting.
Yeah,
trying to become a band that can do that. Because it's, you know, it's a mysterious and strange art in and of itself. Really
completely.
Good dance bands. It's like, it's really something to experience, I think. And
yeah.
So just aiming for that is a new thing for us.
Because you guys met up, James Murphy, yeah, you sort of met up with him a while ago as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where did he sort of tie into things?
When?
When did you meet up with him? And
we actually tried to work with him on Neon Bible, and just because of scheduling, it didn't work.
Yeah, it didn't tee in, yeah.
And then, but we toured with LCD Sound System a bunch, which was great. They were like our favorite live band.
Oh, amazing, right?
Yeah, yeah. And that definitely played into this in no small part, I think. They were just such an inspiring live band, and we just do these long, sort of long arc, long trajectory, very dancey sets, but where like it wasn't just empty dance music, it was real songs and a real artistic whole, but with this amazing danceable bent.
Yeah.
And that was just really inspiring to be around that all the time. Hmm. And even actually the last time we were here with them.
So that was the same year?
Yeah, same year.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And anyway, so it's just kind of been in the works or on the hope list for a long time. And it finally worked out schedule-wise, which was great.
As far as playing a festival, do you enjoy that environment any more than having your own? Because I mean, it's great having your own show where it's all locked down and it's on your own terms.
Mm.
But does a festival have any advantages that you like?
It has the advantage of playing to people that might not normally come to your shows, which is always, it's just nice to play for people who don't necessarily know your songs and haven't seen you before. So that's kind of the main thing with festivals. And then it's nice to just get to be a part of a bigger event and not feel like the entire event is resting on your shoulders. So that's fun.
Yeah, pressure off a little bit.
And it's just, you know, it's nice to play for hip hop fans and nice to play for Pearl Jam fans instead of our own, you know, our own fans.
Did you ever think that you would get, because I mean, you're on a lot of people's, you read about you guys on the internet, and a lot of people, you rightfully say you are one of the biggest bands on the planet at the moment. Did you ever think you would be reading that about yourselves? Was that a little aim or intention?
I don't know. I don't really think about that part of things so much.
Just get on with it and do what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, I think you can't really think about your public perception too much or you'll go crazy, I think. And we mostly try to keep our heads down and work on music and focus on the things which are within our control.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, and not so much think about the things that are outside of our control.
So you're not Googling yourself every day?
No. I mean, you go, like, in the early phases of the band all of a sudden becoming popular and getting on people's radar, you go through a moment of that because you can't not, because there's something weird and fascinating about that, but it's like quickly leave that behind if you're going to stay sane, I think, because it's just not, it's like not a sensible human activity.
Weirdest thing you've read about yourself online?
Weirdest?
Yeah, just something that was just out of unexpected.
To be honest, I really don't. I try not read things about myself online.
Leave it.
I just kind of leave it, and because you know, this like famous adage about never listen to, you know, in terms of making art, like never listen to anything anybody says about you, especially not the good stuff.
No, totally.
Yeah, which is quite useful, I think.
Yeah. Between now and Coachella, what have you got planned? Is it just lots of touring and?
Yeah, we're playing. Yeah. We're doing this. New Zealand and Australia, and then we're going home, and then we're doing some shows in the States, and we're doing a show in Haiti, and we're doing and we're going to South America.
Cool. Because you've done some interesting stuff in Haiti, haven't you? Like, I gather you get a bit of influence from there and some of the music there at times.
Yeah, for sure.
That's like, how did that happen? Was it a random trip there at some point, or you'd heard the music before you'd been?
Not really random. We have done a bunch of fundraising for an organization that works there called Partners in Health. That's an amazing healthcare organization that provides healthcare for poor people. And they just do amazing work there, and we all went there. And it all sort of spiraled out from that.
Because I would love to go there at some point.
You
but
should.
It just looks incredible and rich and
it is
ridiculous.
Incredible. Yeah, it is really, really incredible place. Yeah.
What's the music like there?
It is amazing. It's like it's its own unique hybrid, as is like sort of everywhere in the Caribbean. Have all the different spots in the Caribbean have their own really particular musical hybrids and angles on things, but really rhythmically driven stuff with kind of this religious voodoo drumming influences and these kind of African influences, and then just this kind of Caribbean diaspora. It all mixes and matches in a really interesting way, in a way that's just particular. And they've got kind of incredible just different instruments that they've built there, different it's a whole different thing. It's hard to explain.
Do you find yourself, because I mean with you guys there's a lot of instruments on stage obviously at times, do you take when you're traveling, do you take other stuff in like that and think we could use that or do that?
Yeah, I think sometimes you do it consciously, and sometimes that stuff just happens by osmosis. Yes and no.
Yeah.
You have to be careful with that kind of thing about, you know, just stealing things from other people, but also the history of music is based on everybody stealing things from everybody else, so it's an interesting thing. Yeah. I think where the sort of natural musical, sort of human musical impulse to hear something really amazing and then want to do something like that.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's the thing that all musicians or composers or whatever share. And you do have to be careful about it. And then you just, because people, you know, you can't just steal music from anybody you like and call it your own, but also the history of music is just this total melting pot of things being heard by people from different places and doing their own take on that. And the long answer is yes.
Yes, but not always.
Yes, but not always, and not completely consciously, but trying to do it consciously. And and I don't think there's ever a total black and white answer about that, because it just sort of happens how it happens.
You played in different bands before Arcade Fire, right? With different people.
Yeah.
Is there anything that sort of that when you first became involved in Arcade Fire that you saw as being different, or that you thought there's something quite cool here?
Yeah, I mean, we definitely found something together that felt special and felt like something from the get-go when we were playing together. You know, it was bearing fruit, I guess.
Well, it worked, didn't it?
Sure.
You've done pretty well, you got to admit. It's all working out pretty well.
Yeah, it's working out great.
Yeah. Do you think you'll do this for the foreseeable future? Like, do you see this as being something that you just want to keep? Because you've achieved a lot quite young, you know what I mean? Like, you could go off and score films if you wanted, or, you know, do whatever, you know?
I mean, I am definitely the one in the band who seems to manically keep his hand in many different things all at the same time. I've been composing chamber music the last few years also, and doing production work for other people, and collaborating with different people, just because that's sort of in my nature, and it always was. But I think we'll just keep doing this as long as it feels good, and again, sort of bears fruit and seems like a positive and exciting thing that feels good to do, and sort of all you can set your sights on, really.
Are there any other bands at the Big Doubt that you're keen to see yourself?
I'm actually really excited to see Pearl Jam a bunch. I've only ever seen them once, and they were sort of a big band for me in high school. And we played with them once and have met them, and they're just lovely people. That'll be great. I'm kind of excited to see Snoop a lot.
Yeah.
And I've never seen Tame Impala, but they're a great, really incredible band. So excited about that too.
Cool, man. Well, look, thanks so much for your time. Appreciate you coming down while your bandmates are lost in Auckland somewhere. Is there anything you want to do while you're here in New Zealand? I mean, you've done Piha.
I did Piha. I went to some hot springs. I'm going to go to some more hot springs, I think. Maybe.
Got a lot of hot springs.
Yeah, they're everywhere. It's great.
Just soak.
It's the best.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite things to do in the world. And it so happens that you guys are have them in spades. It's amazing.